Thanks for watching the video. I'm Lena, and this is the LearnStift Pen Plus. To give a little background on the LearnStift Pen, it was launched on Kickstarter recently by two Munich-based entrepreneurs named Daniel and Falk. Their goal was to create a fully autonomous digital pen for note-taking, drawing, and learning via pointing out errors by the user, and it was inspired by their young children who had problems with spelling. However, taking that idea one step further, the pen is capable of so much more, and I'm here to tell you how and why. Currently, the pen is able to only vibrate at the scan of an incorrectly written word using an algorithm that pulls from a dictionary database. The value that I plan to add through the LearnStift Pen Plus includes giving the pen the capability of not only acting as a spell check, but also programming the pen so that it's able to apply literate suggestions to the user's writing as a whole. Using the Linux operating system for its software, the pen's board will contain a motion sensor processor, memory, Wi-Fi, and more. Speaking specifically about certain aspects of the pen, the CPU in the pen would be comprised of three parts: the control unit, where it would fetch and interpret instructions of what writing to correct and how from the RAM, the ALU, which would execute the proper writing alterations and suggestions, and registers, which would act as fast access storage inside the CPU. Eventually, it would be ideal that the pen become more functional and proficient at its job as the user utilizes the pen, since the pen's literary knowledge would expand every time it scanned more documents, files, and papers from the web to compare to the user's writing. In terms of the non-volatile memory that would need to be installed in the pen, something along the lines of flash memory or ROM or CMOS would have to be utilized, since we want the pen to not only correct the writer's entries, but also to predict what the writer would say or how they would say it. For this function to work within the context of the pen, then, all of the writer's entries would have to be saved and referred back to by the pen software. Additionally, attaching a radio frequency ID to the pen via a passive tag could be utilized to read and analyze sentences which the user of the LearnStift Pen Plus would create. These sentences could, in theory, be read as a barcode or EasyPass by the radio frequency ID, referred back to well-noted works of literature via the internet, and stored in the memory compartment of the pen. Just as the radio frequency ID is used in retail to keep inventory, the pen will scan for key sentences, words, etc., and be able to track how the user of the pen is constructing their writing pieces. This project is plausible and can be successful because it has already been started. The creators of the prototype pen only lacked money when it tried to launch in 2013, and since technology spoken about previously has only improved since then, it is bound to work both technically and logistically, as it will encourage modern users to improve handwriting and cognition by demonstrating that writing with an e-pen versus using a keyboard is easy, accessible, and beneficial. To conclude, thanks for watching the video, hope you like the project, and have a great day!